everyone, it's Vania here, trainer from our Wellington location. Today I'm just getting ready to transfer some tomato seedlings that I started into their own individual containers. So before we go any further, make sure you subscribe and hit that like button to help us support our channel. So I started these plants from seed about 6 to 7 weeks ago now, back in mid to late March, and it's time to pot them up into their own little individual containers because they're getting a little bit too big, and you can see that they're starting to get stressed out by some of the yellowing leaves in here. In each individual little cell, I actually have two, sometimes even three plants growing, which means that they are sort of competing for nutrients in the amount of soil that they have. So by potting them up into bigger pots all on their own, you know, they'll start to get more nutrients from the new soil that they'll be placed in. Now, while I'm doing that, I thought it would be good to kind of talk to you about some of the reasons why I started my own vegetable garden, and maybe give you some reasons why you should start your own as well. Now, from a trainer's perspective, I kind of have five reasons why I think everyone should start growing their own vegetables. So number one, it's a great way to spend some time outdoors, get some extra activity in, and you know, stay active and move around. Number two, growing your own veggies actually tastes way better than what you can find from your grocery store. Now, to me, there's really nothing better than being able to go out into your backyard, pick a perfectly ripe tomato, and be able to eat it pretty much immediately. Here in Canada, especially in the wintertime, we get a lot of our produce imported from warmer areas of the world. That involves picking the vegetables or fruit a little bit before when they're perfectly ripe, and then that way they're better able to kind of survive the transport to us. So reason number three, I like that you get access to a lot more different varieties of whatever it is that you'd like to grow. So there's probably hundreds of different types of tomatoes that you can choose to grow alone. And like I said earlier, I actually have six different ones that I'm personally growing. So each variety has its own unique flavor and texture profile. So it's always fun to be able to try out new varieties and taste something new. Reason number four. Now, the superior taste and the ability to try out different varieties means that growing your own vegetables could help even the pickiest eaters learn to enjoy eating different veggies and fruits. So maybe the reason why you don't like tomatoes is because you've only tried ones that you can get from the grocery store, which are actually pretty gross. So the difference in taste is actually so great that it's pretty rare that I even buy tomatoes from the grocery store anymore, particularly in the wintertime. And really, I think the only time I even buy tomatoes from the grocery store is if my husband insists on making pico de gallo instead of just using jarred salsa. And finally, reason number five is that this can be a great way to help your kids learn to enjoy eating vegetables as well and try different things out. Kids tend to, you know, enjoy learning about how things grow and being able to experience it themselves as well. And they seem to be more willing to try something out if they've seen the process take place. So back in the olden days, when we used to be able to have visitors to our house, my nieces and nephews would really enjoy kind of learning about different things that I was growing in my garden. So last summer, my nephew Nicholas in particular had a lot of fun just trying out different things. So we would pick out various leafy greens, and he'd actually just eat them right then and there in the backyard. You know, we did things like digging in the soil for potatoes. So it's something fun that they can take part in, and you know, know, learn about where their food comes from as well. So you can see what I was kind of talking about here, where the leaves are starting to get a little bit yellow. That tells me that, you know, the plant probably wasn't getting enough nutrients, being stuck in the same pod, small pod, as one other plant. So, you know, that's a good sign to let you know if you are growing vegetables from seed on your own, when it's time to separate the plants and, you know, pot them up into a bigger container. So with tomato plants, what I like to do as well is, in order to help grow a nice strong stem, I'll plant them a little bit deeper into the container as well. So what I'll do is snap off these bottom leaves, maybe this one as well. And then, I don't know if you can see these little hair-like things coming up the stems, but with tomato plants, more roots will kind of grow up along the entire stem. That's what these little hairs are. So by planting them a little bit deeper, you know, more roots will start to come out here, and then that way, once it's time to be planted in the garden, you'll know that you'll have a nice strong stem that'll stay rooted throughout the growing season. So this guy here, I have just a little bit of soil down in the bottom, so we'll stick that right in there. Just add additional soil all the way around. All right, so I've now done and transplanted 6 plants, and I only have 11 more to go. Now, you know, I obviously don't have the room for 11 tomato plants. So if you're interested in starting out with your own vegetable garden, I have lots of extras to give away. Leave a comment down below if you'd like to try out gardening and are interested in, you know, picking up a free tomato plant or two from me. I'm happy to share and help somebody out. So thanks again for watching. Before you go, be sure to subscribe to our channel and leave us a like.